good PowerPoint presentation can help you convince anybody to give you what you want. However, making a great one can be quite a tedious and time-consuming process. But what if I told you that you can create persuasive presentations like these ones in just a couple of minutes? In this video, I will show you how ChatGPT can help you create a very strong outline for the presentation, two different methods to import the outline to PowerPoint, and some tips on how to make your presentation look stunning. Let's get into it. The first step is asking ChatGPT to help you create the outline of the presentation. But first, you need to understand that the output of ChatGPT will only be as good as your prompt. So here, it's good to spend some time creating a very good quality prompt. This is how I typically create it. You should start by giving ChatGPT a role depending on the type of presentation that you want to create. Now, in this example, I want to create a sales pitch deck trying to sell a project management tool to my clients. So here, for example, I would start saying, assume you are a business owner with over 15 years of experience and you sell SaaS products to clients. Now, the next step is to give some relevant context and explain to ChatGPT what is the task that needs to be accomplished. For example, in this case, you can write, your team has developed a project management tool to help companies with around, let's say, 100 to 500 employees to streamline their project management processes. This tool is very helpful for companies who are in the transition from a startup to a scale-up. Your goal is to create the outline for an 8-slide presentation that you will be using as a sales pitch deck. Each slide should contain an action-based title, that means specific, concise, insightful, backed with data, and focusing on the main slide takeaway. And it should also contain 3 bullet points backing up the claim that you make in the slide title. Now, at this point, it's also good to emphasize to ChatGPT who is your target audience. So it's always good to add something like, for example, the target audience of this presentation are CEOs of companies that have just surpassed the 100 employee mark and are looking into scaling up. And your goal is to convince them to buy your product. Now, if you're just creating a generic presentation, you can just hit enter and this would be already a good prompt to get a nice outline. But in my case, I really want to create a persuasive and convincing sales deck. So for that, ChatGPT first needs to understand a bit more about my product. That's why I like to finish my prompt adding the following. Before giving me the outline, please ask me any relevant questions you would need to understand better what the product is about. Now, after hitting enter, ChatGPT will ask you a few clarifying questions. Like in this case, you can see it's asking me about what are the core features of my proposition, what are the unique selling points, whether I have any customer success stories that I could use to convince my future clients. It's asking about market research data, it's asking about the pricing strategy, the target audience pain points. So overall, they all make sense, right? I mean, you cannot expect anybody, not even a person, to craft a good sales pitch deck without knowing anything on these areas. So of course, the next step will be answering the questions that ChatGPT has for you. So here it's good to spend a few minutes really detailing out the answers. And at the end, you can add something like, now, please help me create the outline of the presentation. And remember, you should always say please and be polite to AI. You just never know what's going to happen in the future. Now you can hit enter and see how it creates for you the entire outline of the presentation, all in just a few minutes of work. And honestly, this is looking quite amazing already. Now the second step will be bringing the output of ChatGPT into PowerPoint. The way I usually do it is copying the output of ChatGPT into a Word file that then can be used to create the actual slides. But before you can do that, you need to give some formatting to the text. So for example, as you can see, whatever is a slide title, you need to format as a heading 1. And then the bullet points of the slides, you need to format them as heading 2. In this case, I only asked for 3 bullet points per slide, but if you would have subpoints for each of the bullet points, those would need to be formatted as heading 3. Then next step, save the file, and of course you can open PowerPoint, you start a blank presentation, you click on new slide and select slides from outline. Then you just need to locate the Word file you've just created, and just like this, your presentation is. Now, if you don't want to go through all the formatting steps that you have to do on the Word file, you can also ask ChatGPT to provide some visual basic code that can help you generate this presentation. So for example, you ask a prompt similar to this one, and then you copy the code and go to PowerPoint. Once you're in PowerPoint, you need to make sure that you have enabled the developer tab. And the way to do that is by right-clicking on the toolbar, you then click on Customize the Ribbon, and you make sure that developer is selected. Now, once that's ready, you can go to the developer tab, you can click on Visual Basic, wait for it to open, then you go on Insert, Module, and you copy all the code. Once all the code is there, you can just click Play, and the slides will generate in front of you in a moment. Now, in general, you should be careful by using this approach, because usually it's not recommended to copy-paste any code you find out there, and also not any code that you get from ChatGPT. But in this case, this is quite a fast way to do it, so I thought it was good to show you, so you adjust it. Then from here, you can make your slides a bit more beautiful by going into the Designer tab and generate some nice designs for your slides. And of course, if your company already has some pretty fine templates, then you can use those, or you can also find some nice templates on the internet and use those to prettify your slides. And as you can see, this is already looking quite good, but on itself is not really enough to have a great presentation. But here, I have a few more tips for you on how you can use AI to help you complete this deck and make that killer presentation. I think you will agree with me that the presentation without visuals can be quite boring, and sometimes you probably even need graphs to underpin the point that you're trying to make in that slide. So here, for example, you can ask ChatGPT for ideas on visuals that you can use on your slides. For example, a prompt that I like to use is something like this one. Could you please, and again, remember to say please, suggest appropriate visuals or graphs to accompany each of the slides? For each visual, please give me some keywords on how I could find that image on a stock image provider, like for example, on Splash. And if a chart is needed, please indicate what's the best type of graph that I could use in that slide. And just like that, you have in front of you a list of potential visuals that you can use throughout your presentation. Now, many times at work, you are creating presentations that will be used by somebody else. Or maybe they will be presented by you, but you want to make sure that you don't forget mentioning some important elements. That's where the speaker notes come in handy. And here also, AI can help you craft really nice speaker notes. So, for example, you could use a prompt like, for each slide, please create detailed speaker notes highlighting the key elements that should be explained during the presentation of the slides. And just like that, ChatGPT is giving you speaker notes that are relevant for each of the slides, and then you can just grab what it's telling you and copy-paste it into the speaker notes so it's ready for you or for whoever is going to be presenting your slides. Finally, it's also good to understand that most likely, whatever ChatGPT throws at you the first time will not be perfect. But that's fine. Here you can spend some time refining and iterating with ChatGPT based on your needs. So for example, in my case, I'm not really fond of this title in this slide. So I might ask ChatGPT something like, could you please give me 5 alternative titles for this slide that are a bit more data-driven? And just like that, ChatGPT is giving me some alternatives, and then I can look into them and see which one I find more appealing. Or maybe if you don't like any of these, you can still keep on asking questions until you come with the right title that you would like. And you can do that with any element, with the titles, with the bullet points, with the outline, with how many slides, with the structure, with the visuals, pretty much anything. For example, you could also say, how can we make this presentation more engaging for a younger audience? And use that feedback to refine your presentation. And if I look at the final product, it's still not perfect, but it's already pretty decent. Like, if I would have done it on my own, it would have taken me already a few hours of tinkering, how to best structure a presentation, moving things around, and so on. And I think when I was a junior and I was just starting, honestly, this could have taken me an entire afternoon, like 4 or 5 hours to craft this. And now, thanks to AI, I have reduced all that time to just a few minutes, and I can spend the rest of my time like really tuning the details and making the best out of this presentation. I suggest you give it a try and see how it works for you. And to make it easier, I created a cheat sheet that will be available through my newsletter, link to subscribe down below. And if you got any value from this video, please give a like, subscribe, it really helps for the algorithm, and I'll see you next time.